My friends, this is something that I didn't know I wanted until I got it. This is the craziest keyboard that I've come across in my entire time being alive. As you can hear, it weighs a brick, and that's exactly why I love it so much. Today, we're taking a look at the Abcancore AR87 full aluminum keyboard. Aluminum, however I'm supposed to say it. So let's take a look at this. So first up, I want to get this out of the way. I first came across this company when we reached out to them to sponsor our trip to Computex last year. And actually, I don't even know how to say the company name. It's either Abcancore or Abcancore. I'm not quite sure. They never clarified. I said Abcancore for our entire sponsorship and they've never corrected me. Anyways, I came across one of their revisions of this type of keyboard at Computex. So it's called the Black Pearl. And I absolutely wanted to take it home because these keyboards weigh 3.1 kilograms or 6.8 pounds. This is just CNC'd aluminum with cherry key switches on it. It is so big and so heavy and so massive that I don't even know what to do with it. And I don't know why I want it so bad, but I absolutely do. This is the most beautiful keyboard that I've used in my life, not because of its aesthetics, but because of the sheer girthiness of what this thing is. I could kill somebody with this keyboard with very little effort. That is how solid this gosh dang thing is. So obviously that is like the selling point of this keyboard, full aluminum. You typically, if you're getting a full aluminum board, they're either very low profile or they're very special edition, kind of like you have to pick them up on drop.com. This version of the AR87 is just available on Amazon. You can buy it right now, but we need to get the big conversation piece out of the way right up front, which is the price. It's $240 right now on Amazon, which is a lot to spend on a keyboard. So I'm thankful that they sent it to me for me to check out and I didn't actually have to buy it. But that's actually what these types of keyboards typically go for, especially ones that are made out of full metal. I've seen several others that have gone on drop.com. You have the NYM 84 and 96. Those were roughly 200 euros with the keycaps. So you actually had to pay extra for the keycaps. The AR87 has the keycaps and full aluminum, but one of the nice things is that it also does have RGB. You can actually see that it is a Type-C connector to go to your PC, which is quite nice. It's what you want in 2020 is a Type-C connector. And then you get glorious side glow RGB, but not on the keys, which I want to talk about the keycaps for a second. They have this like cream look to them, which I'm not sure we're gonna be able to capture on camera. This A-roll, they just look plain white, but in reality, they're actually more like the IBM Model M type color of the keycaps, which I think suits the beefiness of this AR87. I'm personally gonna be replacing the keycaps just because I'm doing a custom themed build and setup for my PC station. So this isn't gonna fit me. However, I think it does come across more classy and refined with just the aluminum shell and then the SideGlow RGB and the very old school looking cream keycaps. Unfortunately, one of the downsides of this board is that the switches are not hot swappable. You're stuck with whatever you get in them. However, they do have full Cherry MX switches. You can get them in blue, brown, red, silent red, and black. So you have options as far as the switches, but you cannot replace them if you break them. I did have the idea of driving over this keyboard with my car, but then I realized if I break a switch, I can't replace it. If it had hot swappable switches, you bet your bottom dollar I would have driven over this thing because it is a beast. So form factor wise, it's a 10 keyless. It actually is more compact than your typical 84 key keyboard. The F row up top is actually a lot closer to the main section of the keyboard than on typical setups. Quite good. It has 1000 hertz pulling rate. It's got USB Type-C, as I mentioned. The shell for it is slightly sloped to make more comfortable typing. The keycaps themselves are PBT. They're dye sublimated. They're 1.4 millimeters thick. It has full end key rollover, and you've got the LEDs for the caps lock and scroll lock that are right there. So everything is set up in this keyboard. It's everything that you would want in a high-end premium keyboard. I would prefer hot swappable switches in this, but that's obviously not one of the reasons why you get it. You're gonna be hard pressed to find a full aluminum keyboard like this that's also gonna have hot swappable switches. We've also got Drop.com sent us their control keyboard, which is also made out of aluminum. However, the weight of this comes in at 1.9 kilos or 4.2 pounds. So it's a full 2.5 pounds lighter. It is aluminum, but it also does have things like RGB side glow around the entire thing. However, this thing does have fully hot swappable switches that you can work on. It's also thinner, but I think the selling point of the AR87 is the fact that it is so chunky. It's just a gigantic keyboard. Like, I thought the control at 4 pounds was heavy, but it's not. It's not at all. This is lightweight compared, like having the difference. I can't even explain the physical substantive difference of having a 4.2 pound keyboard to a 6.8. It's just a completely different feel. This thing will go nowhere on your table. The Drop Control, however, is $10 more expensive, but you do get more RGB with it. So if you're somebody who wants more flash, more RGB, the Control might be the way to go. However, the AR87 is for that more refined, subdued look. It's just the keyboard with the Slide Glow RGB and not much else to look at. It does come with a very heavy duty carrying case. You saw me chuck it down on the table at the beginning of the video. On top of the keyboard, you do get the USB Type-C cable, as well as a keycap puller and a little brush to dust everything off, as well as a nifty little manual to let you know of all the FN combination functions that the keyboard's capable of. So that's basically the keyboard in a nutshell. It has N-key rollover, does everything you want it to do. I have it in the brown switches, which type phenomenally. I love this thing to death, but it leads me to the question of who needs this. And the truth be told, $240 keyboards is not for your everyman. This is for the person who actually cares very much about the aesthetics, the overall quality, and the build of their keyboard. And this doesn't even scratch the total of high-end keyboards that you can possibly get. It's not unheard of to spend hundreds of dollars on keycaps, let alone an actual keyboard of this magnitude. However, this is one of the only fully retail available, fully aluminum chassis keyboards that I can find on the market right now. There have been several iterations that I've seen that have gone through drop.com, but they're not available currently. I haven't found anyone that's not a low profile one, like for a Mac, that's available on Amazon. Abcancore or Abco Encore is filling that niche little market where you have a heavy duty brick, a full aluminum in a keyboard, but also not be super low profile like you would want on a Mac. This is not for everybody. And I'm not even sure it's for me, because I don't even appreciate high-end mechanical keyboards the way that I probably should. It's not an area that I've invested a ton of time into. However, after seeing this, after playing around with the Drop Control, I do think that I do want to get into more of the high-end keyboard game, maybe even build my own mechanical keyboard. That could be a project that we work on here, but I am thankful that they sent me this because I absolutely love it. I didn't realize how much I would love a brick of a keyboard. Obviously, this doesn't make a lot of sense for a lot of people because of the price. It also doesn't make a lot of sense for shipping because it's freaking 7 pounds. It's gonna cost you an arm and a leg to tote this thing around if you're like a small retailer trying to ship this across the globe. So only a company like Amazon does it make sense to have this in a retail environment. So I love it. Abcancore has made a phenomenal keyboard. It hits all the boxes that you would want it to. It does everything you would want it to besides not having hot swappable switches, but it's a sturdy keyboard. I love it very much. I'm thankful that I have it. Should you buy it? Probably not, unless you're already in the market for a very, very high-end keyboard. This is gonna be a very niche product. But if there's anything else that you want me to check out in the high-end keyboard market, let me know down below in the comments. Is this something that you want me to check out on the regular? Obviously, as I get more experience with these higher-end keyboards, the more commentary I'm gonna be able to provide on them and have insight into everything. But after this, I think I'm ready to enter the high-end keyboard game. I love it. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye. It scares Catlin. That's why I do it. It's fun. I'm gonna drop the keyboard on the table, just so you know. It's part of the video.
Okay.
All right? You're welcome. Prepare your ears, or your heart, rather.